Hi, YouTubers! So let's go ahead and let's talk about EA Gate. Why not? Might as well. It's funny. Most people when I talk to about EA games and sports titles, a lot of people look at me and they ask me, wait, you play sports titles? And sometimes I do. But I'm not an idiot. I'm not one of these people that's going to spend hundreds of dollars inside a Madden game or inside the latest version of FIFA. No, I buy last year's game. So it's kind of funny, and here's why. Sports games don't hold their value. And because they don't hold their value, why am I going to pay $70 to play a sports game when next year I can get that same title for $3.99? And I wish I was joking. That's literally how badly they don't hold their value. And I don't care about online play at all. If I cared about the online play, I'd go and play online with people. I don't care about online play. If I'm going to play a sports game, I want to play by myself versus the computer. That's it. That's my idea of fun. They're cheap games. $3.99. Hey, I'm there. $3.99. No problem. I'll be there. Perfect. You know, absolutely great. The last best version of Madden that I've ever played that I owned was Madden 09. And that was on the PlayStation 2 because it had family mode and it actually taught players how to play the game. But in Madden 2010, EA thought it was a good idea to remove family mode because it's not profitable. So, honestly, that's my view. If I'm going to buy a sporting game at all, I don't care about the DLC, the microtransactions. I play it for fun. I don't play it to win. I don't play it to be some hose-knobbing a-hole that loves his sport so much that he wants to beat the crap out of everybody online to make the perfect team. I don't care about that. And the sad thing is over the years with different Madden games, we've lost that. We've actually lost the playability, and it's now been masked by greed, spending money, greed, spending money, greed, greed, greed. And that's why I stopped playing sports games that were new. Because if I can buy a used copy next year for $3, why am I going to spend $70 for a game that absolutely sucks? That's the latest version. Something to really think about, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, I don't buy current sports games because they're cheaper when you buy old ones. Now, I thought at first that them putting loot boxes inside FIFA, inside all these other games, is pretty terrible. And then they did the stupid thing with UFC. UFC, they went through and they decided it was a great idea to go ahead and add advertisements into UFC 4. What's shocking, those same advertisements ended up showing up in UFC 3 as well. Last year's game. So I'm like, wait a minute. So you updated last year's game to add ads to piss off your customers even more. Classic Electronic Arts. Again, that's why I don't buy current sports titles. I buy maybe last year's or the year before that because I can get the games for $4 a piece. Thank you for your time. That's how I feel about EA Gate. I think that they're stupid, I think they're arrogant, and I hope Electronic Arts learns their lesson from how terrible their game review currently is. Thank you.